one to be means unknown. But then you have to apply a correction. In that correction, this revolution will number will come. In fact, very major thing is which, you know, we have myself, British Invas and Ram Subramanian, we have worked on that, that led to the kind of a heliocentric model propounded by Nilakantha Swami. He changes the phenomena. He said, Shigrocha, even for sun it is. Sun is there, Shigrocha. And what was referred to as Shigrocha earlier is actually the planet. So then he said that actually planets move around the sun and the whole thing moves around the earth. So we are not going to those details. It has got some meaning. It is heliocentric planet. Then retrograde evolutions of moon's nodes. Okay, so moon's this thing orbit, if I show the sun, this thing, sun's move around the ecliptic, moon does not move around the, most of the planets also move near this. See, they are all going this thing, but slightly inclined. Moon's orbit is inclined. See, this is 23.5 degrees roughly. Whereas moon's, it varies actually, it will be starts from 4.5 to nearly 5.5 degrees. The inclination of the moon's orbits. So this intersection points. So this is the Rahu and Ketu, ascending and descending node. These are the Rahu and Ketu. Okay? And they also have a motion. You see, they will move this way. All the planets move this way, this will move this way. It's called retrograde motion. And that also is given in all the books and certainly in Siddhanta Siromani also. That is this. And the number of civil days in a kalpa, how many sunrises are there? Okay? So that is the called the Savana Dina, that is this number. 15779 1645 followed by 4. So from these numbers one can find the sidereal periods of the planets and then upsides and lows. Okay? So this many days is there. See, for instance, if you want to find a Jupiter period, you just have to divide this by this. So that will tell how many days Jupiter takes to complete one revolution. So that will be nearly 12 years, 12 into 365. You will get it. But how does one ascertain this number? Bhaskara discusses this. Bhaskara states that the scriptures are all the authorities for these numbers. Okay? So, suppose some people in our country, as soon as they see these scriptures of the authority, they start screaming. See, they don't have any scientific spirit. They are saying, you know, scriptures of the authority, this, that, and all that, you know. There will be hue and cry, television debates and all that. But you have to go a little further. What he is saying, you know, that is the report. He says, however, for a long period of time, the numbers can get changed in transmission due to mistakes generated by the scribe, the teacher, and the people. So one has to somehow remedy the situation and find it. So he said only the upapatti or the method. In fact, the method he will refer to is, you know, mathematical, you know, method determines the number of revolutions. However, the number of revolutions cannot be determined directly, as the sidereal periods of the upside and lows and even planets are standing itself for long. Okay? So Bhaskara discusses the strategy for finding the revolution numbers in the Vasana for verses 1 to 6 in Bhagavad-gyaya. So we discuss the method, how we find the sidereal, how, what is the method we use for the sidereal period of the sun. So what he is saying is written in Sanskrit here, Grihana, Purva, Gatya, this is the Vasana. I am not going to Sanskrit because some of you may not know. So planets make these any number of revolutions towards each in a kalpa. Similarly, this other things, apogees and all that, don't bother about it. They are made by the nodes and all. So how do, here is the rationale. This rationale can only be understood by a person having knowledge of language, geometry, and well versed in the geometry of spheres, and not by anyone else. Naturally, one has to know some astronomy, language of astronomy, mathematics, to, you know, find what is the matter. So only scriptures for the specified number of revolutions, okay, for a, in a kalpa made by the planets and other mandala charts. See, by Gita, what he means is the authoritative text. Even if you want to know what is there in quantum mechanics, you have to find authoritative text in this. It doesn't mean that you are unscientific, right? If there may be some little bit of problem, anyway, scientists will do research on that. So he says, over a long period of time, large errors are accumulated because of the mistakes. Let's say Aryabhatiya is there, or some other Brahman Buddha Siddhanta is there. So they are transmitted from generation to generation, manuscripts are there and all that. He says, the errors may be there in even writing the numbers. Okay? By scribing the people to be, you see. So whatever he writes. So the next order of transmission is the teacher. Teacher is teacher. He also may introduce some small mistake. And pupil, when he is taking it down, okay, he may also commit it. So all these things may be there. You should take it into account. Then, how can these scriptures be authoritative? Here it is told that the authority of the scriptures is established by mathematical demonstrations only. Ganita skanda upapatti. So it very clearly says that the ultimate authority is mathematical demonstration and experiments. Ultimate authority. The number of revolutions obtained in method upapatti are considered. Not only that, a very intelligent man can understand the upapatti well. However, it is not possible to find the quality number, quantity number of revolutions made by him. Because Shani takes nearly 30 years. So, person, you know, do these things. Earlier people may not be living for a long time, you see. At the age of 40. So suppose he starts the observation at the age of 50. He will not be able to trace revolution. Because by before 45 he has made an upward journey. So you have to do some other method, you see. Because of the short length of human being. So in the upapatti, the planet is to be observed daily by an instrument called Earth. So he takes first the simplest thing is a sidereal revolution, sidereal and revolution number of the sun. He uses a method of finding the exact length of the solar year. On level ground, a circle is and the east, west, north, south directions are wrong. I have already told you how to find the east-west direction. Perpendicular to that is north, south, right? At the center of the circle, is fixed. And the direction of sunrise is noted as the circle using the field. So then, with this, make the observations and find out how. See, what he says is the following. I will not read out all the things. So this is the point about the analytics, from where observations are made. To write a big circle, draw a big circle. So this one night is day. Okay? And sun's shadow has to be found. Okay? And so this, suppose it is at some S1 on some particular day. He says near the equator. When sun is near the equator, you do it. March 19th or March 18th. Do it. Okay, then it will keep changing. It will go. Okay, east west motion will be there, it will go. It will change. He says after 365 days, at one day it is yes, and the first day of observation is yes. See, after 365 days, okay, it will not be at the same point because sun is making a one tour, in 365 and a quarter, we know that. So after 365, come to the same point. Okay, it will be somewhat south of this point. So that is this one. Okay. Now after 366 days, again it will not come, it will be somewhat north of that. It will be S2. So did you get the point? Now, the observation is this. So after 360, this is the direction of the sun's, the night shadow due to sun. Yes. After 365 days, it is this one. 36 days, it is this two. After one day. Of one day after this, it is this. So from this, he says, you can find out this thing, the exact duration of the year by long proportion. Okay? So, because this will take one day. S1 to S2 it will take. But how much this will take, S1 to S take? So that's what we want. So these by law of proportion. So we just have to divide all SS1 by all S1S2. That will do the fraction. Yes, so all S1S2 corresponds to one day. Or S1 okay, corresponds to a fraction of the day. So by law of proportion, which is all the time he is using in algebra, geometry, everywhere, Bhaskara uses Trairashika. And Anupata by Anupata you do this, he says. So that's what he is doing. So this is the. So he says, Ata Samaya, Bhubhava, Vishta, Karkatakaina, Vijjavita, Sankai, Anki, etc. So he is describing the method. So he says that. If this, so of course, S1S and S2 is part of some of the difficulties. So, if the S1S corresponding to 365, one day 60 ghatikas. So, that also was told earlier to you. What is it for the difference between each point and the southern direction? So, here by applying rule of 3, we obtain 15 ghatikas, 30 palas, and 24 and a half vipalas. This added to 365, number of civilians in the solar area. So what it means is, you know, it's hexadecimal notation which also was. So 365, 15, 30, then 22, 30. So this actually means 365 plus 15 by 60, 30 by 3600 plus 22 by 3600 is what it stands. So this is the sliding wheel. Okay, but now there is a slight this thing, because that is why one has to see the thing carefully. He says that this is the method given is for the tropical year. See how sun is actually moving in the shadow. That depends upon the tropical considerations, you know. Not the fixed star. The what the value is given is sidereal year. So what I meant mean is that you see this this iron this it moves backwards. Okay? So the equator changes orientation, you see. So next year it will be like this, it will be only a small angle, 50 seconds. Okay? So then, when from equinox to equinox, when it goes, it will not be full circle, not 50 degrees, but 360 degrees minus 50. Whereas from here to here, Mesha to Mesha, Mesha to Mesha, that is 360 degrees. So one has to, tropical year is 360 to 462 days. Whereas sidereal is 365.258 something like that. So, but he has not clarified it very well in Siddhanta Siromani. So that's why one has to look at other things. But Nrisimha Devagna in Vasana Vatika, he says that Vasana method is for the tropical year, become the sidereal year when the correction in time corresponding to the motion of the equinoxes. So he feels that Vasana value he gives it after adding the motion of it. So similarly, Bhaskara will go on and work sidereal periods of moon and planets and all. But he gives the method. So we will take something in Gola Jaya. Whereas Bijaganita gives most of the algorithms of Indian astronomy and versus in the detail. Explanations and derivations of these in Vasana Bhakya. Bola Gaya provides the definitions of various astronomical variables, conceptual matters and explanations. It is focused on spherics, as the name suggests. It provides the basis for computations in Bijaganita. Bijaganita explains the algorithms. For instance, how to get the planetary, to use the full method, but details of the planetary model, whole object. Similarly, other things. So we have the chapters are mean and two longitude, three prashna, eclipses, all those things are there in Varadhyaya. So the other question is Bhuvana Kosha or Asma Bhrati with a detailed description and how it is situated unsupported in space, constructed in the ordinary sphere and a chapter called Yantra Dhyaya with the use of simple but effective instruments is described. There is a chapter in seasons, a prashna dhyaya, which poses a very interesting exercise based on earlier chapters. So at the end we have Jyotpatti, a generation of science. So science is important, sine cosine is very important in astronomy calculations. These are, that's how they were developed. Trigonometry developed because of astronomy only. So all the major developments in astronomy. Okay, so just like the king of sciences. Now, astronomy was the most important exact science earlier, before Newton. So all the mathematical methods, many of the mathematical developments are developed in the context of astronomy. So especially trigonometry, even calculus also. Okay, instantaneous state of motion of planets and all that, in that context, calculus also developed. So you use the concept in the sine table, okay? So and he said the celebrated composition, the sine of, you know, the sine of A plus B, sine A cos B plus cos A sine B, or sine A minus B is sine A cos B minus B. Okay. So these are the bhavana. So plus samasa bhavana and antar bhavana, like that. It's called a composition law. So it's more interesting that this appears for the first time here. We have qualitative explanation the various concepts apart from composition aspects. Be it the circumstance under which a star becomes circumpolar, nature of polar and polar eclipses, parallax, physics of moon and so on. So we mention only a few of these as representative examples. So, for instance, it talks about Earth unsupported in space. What happens? For instance, in Bhuvana Kosha, it says, if the Earth was supported by any material substance or living creature, then that could have been supported by another, that talks of another, and it changes. If the last of the why not the first, that is the earth? But is not the earth one form of the eightfold divinity? So in Sanskrit it says, Murto dharta te dharitya tato anyaha tasyapi anyaha tasyayam atra anavastha antye kalpyaye che pashakti ki madhye kim no bhumehe sa aptam muteshya murtihi. So it's a very important thing, because some Puranas and others is there, you know, the earth is supported by some Ashtagajas or, you know, these things are tortoises and all that. Then they need some support and that again needs some support. So it becomes endless. So, but suppose it has to stop somewhere, something is unsupported. So what he is saying is, if that last thing is unsupported, why not the first thing itself? Earth itself. So that is it. Okay. Antye kalpya che swashaktihi. Kim adhye, kim no. You see, why not the beginning itself? So it's a very important thing, because in many of the Jaina, Buddhist texts and all that, your adipati is falling and things like that. So Bhaskara discusses this also in Bhaskara. So if you ask to fall, in which direction will it fall? All directions are equivalent, you know. So it is just lying unsupported. So this kind of explanation is, description is there in other works also, like Tanta Sangraha and Yuti Deepika and all of their things. Now, Dhi Yantra. So, Dhi Yantra, the genius instrument, Dhi, you know, Dhi means Buddhi, this kind of a thing. It is just a staff, it is very useful for measuring various physical body is of interest. Okay, anyway, what is the use of voluminous literature or of humorous instrument for a legal intelligent man? Let him only take a staff in his hand and look at any given object doing it. Along with his eyes from time to from its end to the top. So he can find out nothing in the world of which he will not tell if it is visible, whether in the heavens, on the ground or in the water on the earth. So Vasara goes on to describe how it can be used to of a plate, distances and height of objects and earth, depth and breadth of a water body and so on. So in a very beautiful poetical sense, you know, Divi Bhumi Jalastam Shorchate Tham Shalastam. Only Vasara can write that nice little thing while treating science. So Divi in the world, heaven, Bhumi, earth, Jalastam in the water. So you can find out the locating the things, you know, find out where it is, the dimensions of this and so on. I have described that in detail. Okay, I have not written that. Okay. So what he is saying, he just said, so it's just a stick, that's all he is referring to. So just a stick. So from that itself, you know, by suitably manipulating it, one can find out various things. Okay? That's what he is saying. Okay? In fact, this is a pattern in the whole, see, only 17th century telescopes came. So before that, people used to do, not only Indians, others also, Greeks or Arabs or Babylonians and all that, that used some sticks or tubes. See, to visualize the planets, where are they are and all that. So find out the position, they used to do that. So they used to have more and more accurate, you know, you'll get when time advanced. So Tycho Brahe, for instance, made huge amounts of them. All with, you know, sticks and various kinds of things. Or some instruments which are big. So like Jantar Mantras which are there, you know, in Delhi, it is there, in Ujjain, it is there. See, for instance, he talks about how you find out the latitude of a place. Okay? So, suppose this is your, one person is there. Okay? I just represent like this. So now, you have already fixed the north-south direction, you see? North-south direction. So what is it? Okay? So what he is saying is that you just have to use the stick, so this is some kind of a stick, so that it points to the North Pole, okay, Dhruva Nakshatra. So you try to put it in that direction, or you have to stand in the direction of north, you know, you have to put it like this. So this is sufficient, okay. So what is here is the following. Now how much, so this is even, you know, this is level of your eye, okay. So when it pointing at this, how much is this? Pointing at 0, and suppose this is D0, so then suppose this is 5, so then clearly tan 5 is equal to H0 by D. So what he is saying is find out H0, so you do it and then draw the line to the ground, so see how much is the side and this distance. Okay? So that's tan. Of course they don't give you tan 5, they use sine function and cosine function. But from sine function and cosine function we can find this out. So anyway, this 5 can be determined, latitude can be determined. Similarly, he gives an example of how to find a height of a bamboo tree. So discuss this in detail. Okay, suppose this is your person. Okay, I'm just representing like this. Okay, so bamboo tree is there. So you have to find this distance as well as the height of this. Okay, this is the bottom of the bamboo tree. So this is the top of the bamboo tree. So what is it that you can in Mora Jaya it is there? See, this is the level of your eye. So first this stick is there like this. Then direct the stick such that it is in the direction of the boot of the bamboo. So this one, like this. So now you find out this distance and this distance, okay? Suppose this is some D1 and suppose this is, you do it by observation. The observation you find out from your level of height how much you should, you know, deviate to find a this thing, the base of the bamboo tree. So this suppose the height you fall, height of fall is H1 and this is D1, okay? So then you see by law of proportion, this suppose the fall is at H1, okay? By law of proportion, see this triangle and this triangle, big triangle, they are similar, okay? So H1 by D is equal to small H1 by D1. Okay, that is the height of the person. This is known. Okay, so D is equal to H1 into D1 by D1. So you can find the distance of the bamboo tree. Now you have to find the height of the bamboo tree. So for that, again you do the other observation to find the top of the. Again you do that. Okay, suppose this is H2. Again, you directly subject it is in the direction of the top of the bamboo tree. And suppose it is H2, so then it is D2. This is known. H2 and V2 will point out the experiment, you know, find out by observation. Okay. So then H2 by D is equal to H2 by D2. So H2 is already known. So you find out D is known, H2 and D2 by observation. So H2 is known. So the total height of course is H1 plus H2. So you are finding the, you know, the location by this thing using the this observation. The distance is known. And then so from then you find out the H1 is nothing but the height of the observer. So then the total height, you have to do another observation and so H is remaining. So this is how it is. So how much time do you have? 5 minutes? Yeah, I will get 5 minutes. Yeah, so now while zenith distance, okay, again the sun's path, suppose the sun's path is this, so this is the celestial sphere or bhagola, okay, north south direction and all that, this is the equator, okay, this is the diagonal circle of the sun. Sun is here at some time, okay, so how much time it has taken, see when it is at this meridian, okay, at the place meridian, north, south and zenith, you know, it's called Dakshinottara Vrutta, okay, in Sanskrit, or Yamyottara Vrutta, okay, and Z is Khamadhyā, you know, Khamadhyā, that is the set of these things, okay. Now from here, it was at here at noon, okay, it was here, okay, then it is here now. How much time has elapsed? The time is measured along the equator, you see. This has to do with rotation of the earth. So time is, you know, related to the motion along the equator. So H, this is called hour angle. It's called hour angle in modern astronomy. In Sanskrit it's called Nata. Okay, Nata. Natamsha. Hour angle in degree is called Natamsha. Okay. So remember that 24 hours is equal to 360 degrees. So 1 hour is 15 degrees. So you can find from the degree, you can find out the time. How much time has elapsed after sun has
not the meridian.
So that is the thing. So one can find out the formula for that using spherical trigonometry. So you should know the latitude of the place, declination of sun, and the zenith distance. If you know these things, so then you can find out the hour angle. And Bhaskara derives this in a very physical way of deriving it. This technical, I can't go into detail. He derives this expression. Okay, how to find out the distance in the Triprashtadhikara. The various circles and all that he'll describe, and you can derive this. So using this, the concept for the Phalaka Yantra are based on the above, the Phalaka Yantra. So it is devised by Bhaskara himself to measure it. So he says, Dhrungmandalecha Sputakala Ukta Sukenana Anyehi Yajitam Mayataha Sadgola Yukte Ganitasya Saram Spattam Prabhakshe Phalakakya Yantra. As others have not stated the determination of correct time from observations using a vertical circle with these, I have attempted to devise an instrument called Phalaka Yantra, which incorporates the essential calculations based on the two rationales pertaining to the sphere, which I will explain to you. Okay. Phalaka is, you know, Sanskrit word is Phalaka. It is a rectangular board, kind of thing, on which a circle is drawn. So this is a rectangular board, okay? It is a circle is drawn, you see? So as I briefly, I will just take about 2 minutes to draw a circle, okay? So now, see sun, whichever direction it is there, you draw a vertical circle, you know, that's called a vertical circle. Vertical circle, you see? So, it's called Dhrungmandala. So now, this is the zenith distance. Okay, so now hour angle you have to get, but only zenith distance you are getting. So what we do in the form, you place it, okay, sun is in the equilibrium, you place it like this, okay. Then there is a line here, you see the shadow, from the shadow only you have to find. Suppose it is along this direction. So now you take this OM, such that this is, you know, cos phi by cos delta, R divided by cos phi, cos delta, okay. So that is the OM, okay, and then because this is Z, so this will be cos Z divided by cos phi cos delta, okay. This will be R into cos Z by cos phi cos delta, that one. But you have to subtract something from that, okay. It is called Charajya, incidentally. We have to subtract that. So he says that this has to be subtracted. So this is the thing subtracted. This portion must be subtracted, okay, corresponding to Charajya. So what you do is this, you make it is of some cos phi cos delta, and then you this point you take, then draw it so that it touches the circle, okay. Then you join it to the center of the circle. So this will give the hour angle. One can show very clearly. This is simple geometry. So these are things, okay. It's a very nice kind of a thing. So like that, he has got many other instruments also. So he gives this. He gives all this description in detail. He explains it also. I mean, we explain it. So it's time to.